Hello guys, I hope you're well. Today I'll be introducing our new product, which is a vaccine cold box. It's used to store vaccine for transportation. It's part of the cold chain process because you have to be able to keep the vaccine within range at all time. So this vaccine cold box, it's a Minus40 product, and it is 7 liter vaccine cold box. You can see from the outside, on the left hand side right here, we have all the product information. It is short range cold box, and then it's also a 7 liter. And then what you're also gonna see, that is the stainless steel handle that we use. We also use stainless steel LITRE as well. And then we have our Minus40 logo here. It also embossed right there on the top. And there's also a stop sign. Do you need to open it? This is just a safety sign, a warning sign, because you don't want to open unnecessary the vaccine box. We also have another handle right on the left hand side, and then we also have our hinges right at the back. You can be able to open the lid at 90 degrees for easy loading of vaccine. I'll open the vaccine cold box. So what you'll see, it's open, and then it's at a slightly angle higher than 90 degrees. And then what you'll see is the information on how to load your vaccine. And then inside, there's a product manual that comes with the cold box. And there's also 24 ice pack. So this particular vaccine cold box is designed with 24 ice pack. The ice pack you can either use, or depending on the vaccine that you want to transport, you have to cool them between 2 and 8, or you have to freeze them depending on the vaccine that you want to use on the cold box. And the other thing that we supply as an additional extra is the lock tag. It's a U316 you can put inside your cold box just for recording purposes, just to check the performance of the cold box and to track the quality of your vaccine as well. So there's what I will do now. I'll do a demo on how to pack your vaccine cold box. So I'll remove all 24 ice pack. You'll see it also a Minus40 product. So I'll remove all 24. You have to use just tap water to fill. And there's also a fill line right there, so you're never gonna be able to overfill or anything like that. You just have to make sure that you secure the cap so that the water does not leak. Okay, you can see I've removed all the ice pack, and you can see the inside of the 7 liter vaccine cold box. And then what I will do, I will just gonna do a demo with dummy vaccine box. I will try and pack the vaccine cold box. So the first thing you have to do, we're gonna start with the first instruction. And then the other thing you need to note is that this vaccine cold box have been tested, and then it's rated cold life is 60 hours at 43 degrees Celsius with 24 number of liter of frozen ice packs. So I will first do the first instruction, which is to load 18 ice packs. And then what I will do is I will load the first 6 at the bottom, and then I'll put the remaining 12 around the cold box. Okay, I have finished the first 6, and what I will do, I'll now put the 12. Yeah, so this is how it will look as soon as you load the first 18 ice packs. So the next thing, as soon as you're done loading the 18 ice pack, the next thing you have to do, you have to take your vial or your vaccine box, and then you have to put it inside that range. So what will happen now is that I will use dummy vaccine box, because we can be able to it is 7 liter, so I will use a dummy vaccine box which will fill the 7 liter capacity. So one here is 1 liter, And this block is also another liter, which make 2 liters. And then the next one, make it 3 liters. And then there's also the fourth one, which make it 4 liters. And then I also have each of these is a half of a liter, which gonna make it 5 liter. So I still have 2 liter to go. And then my last blocks is 1 liter each, and then it's half of a liter, and then which make it 2 liter, and then 6. And then there we go. As you can see the setup from the inside, I have now my 7 liter. And then as soon as I'm done placing my vaccine box, and then I have to put a divider in the middle. Okay, so I have a divider in the middle just to secure the vaccine between the box. We don't want them to shake at all time. And then the next thing I will do is I finish step 2 and step 3. So now I will do step 4, which is to load 6 IPEC on the top. So this is the last 6. Okay, and then as you can see, I've secured the whole vaccine boxes. So I have first the 18, and then I have the 12 around it, and the last 6 from the top. And then as soon that I've done so, what I have to do is if I have a lock tag, I can just start my lock tag by clicking the start key, and then there should be a delay of half an hour. And then what I'll do next, I can leave my lock tag inside the vaccine box. And then I can leave it inside. And then now we're doing the last part, which you have to place the foam and close the lid. And then the next thing you do, just if you're strong enough, or 2 people, you can carry the vaccine box and then put it in your car. And then if you want to go to site, you're more than welcome to do so. And then when you go to site, and then you just need to open following the same procedure, and that's it. Thank you.